Air hockey was developed in the late 60s and early 70s by a group of American billiard engineers. When in play, the puck floats on a thin cushion of air, propelled by players at each end. With no friction, the puck moves fast, making air hockey a high-speed game. In a game of air hockey, the puck levitates ever so slightly, made possible by a constant flow of air flowing through perforations in the playfield. The playfield is made from a laminated composite material that's been printed with air hockey graphics. A computerized drill cuts into three playfields at once in the same consistent pattern. The size of the holes are a little larger than pinholes, creating over 4,600 perforations in each air hockey playfield. An automated tool carves grooves in a sheet of medium-density fiberboard. The board will serve as a base for the playfield. Air will circulate in the grooves and exit through the playfield holes. Next, sawdust is blasted out of the grooves. The grooves fiberboard moves through a glue applicator. The rubber roller coats the top of the board with a small amount of glue, so it doesn't seep into the grooves. As the board exits, technicians move the board onto a stack. Once the board is in the correct position, the laminate is applied and aligned with the grooves in the fiberboard. A cardboard cover is placed on the laminate for protection as the stack moves through a press. The weight of the press squeezes the stack together, ensuring adhesion as the glue cures. Meanwhile, a craftswoman applies stick-on graphics onto the side apron boards. She opens a pre-cut slot for a coin door and exposes a hole for a bolt. She cuts open a slot for maintenance access and removes the panel that will serve as a door. She numbers the door and the side apron piece so she can match them up later during installation. After applying artwork to the end panels, another technician assembles curved corner parts and links metal brackets to the side apron parts. He installs a bracket for a puck deflector in the center of the end panel and screws down the corner connectors. He sets the end panels in an upside-down position on the work surface and attaches the sideboards to the corner connectors. This completes the table apron. A locked door is installed in the plywood floor. This will serve as an interior storage compartment. Next, a craftsman installs the coin door and secures it into place. He mounts wire speakers that project sound effects to a computerized optical system that tracks the puck's movements. Once the structure is fitted with wooden panels, the game's flashing lights and sensor activators are installed. At another station, a team flips a playfield over to work on the back. One technician attaches a board above the open grooves, creating a chamber for airflow. The motor and fan are installed over the small opening. This system will blow air into the grooves and the playfield perforations. The playfield is turned over and lowered onto the table structure. Next, aluminum bumpers are attached to the table's border as a barrier for the puck during play. A technician installs goal puck deflectors on the ends and screws in metal plates over the deflector cups. He installs a lock on each goal compartment so no one can steal the puck. Finally, the air hockey table assembly is complete. Let the games begin.